Good morning, everybody. This is Sangeeta Saxena, editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from Eurosatory 2024. We are here at Parc des Expositions of Paris, and this is day three. And I'm here at MKU, and with me I have Karan, who is the Vice President International Sales. Karan Gupta, huh, to be precise. And Karan, welcome to ADU's chat room. Wonderful to have you here. How has it been going on? This is day three.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for coming again to the MKU stand. And as always, we're extremely happy to be present at Eurosatory. This is our 10th or 12th edition to this show. And it is one of the biggest shows in the world for the defense and aerospace industry. And as always, we've come to this show with some of our latest developments and solutions, which are extremely user focused, and our team has worked hard in developing these solutions.
Wonderful. And this is day three. How have the last 2 days been?
The last 2 days have been extremely productive. We have had a lot of official delegations meeting with partners, vendors going on. So yes, I think it is going extremely well.
And you know, you already have a very established European market. So what extra do you expect out of it?
So I would tell you about the two new solutions or three new solutions that we have launched at Eurosatory. They're not only focused for the European market but for the world, like everything else we do. We're launching in this show for the very first time a range of body armor solutions focused for female soldiers and law enforcement officers. We see a growing demand for equipment which is focused for the female officers, and within Europe, more and more countries today have been building up conscription armies and forces where even women are actively joining those forces, and the regular body armor which was being made was just not appropriate for the female body. So keeping this in mind, we have launched a new range of solution for the female officers. We have also launched an extremely lightweight night vision monocular, which is one of the lightest in the market, weighing less than 290 grams, which is here on display. We're showcasing our aviation night vision goggles. So yes, a lot of new exciting solutions for the European market and for the world as well.
Wonderful. And in addition to European markets, you also see here the Middle East and a little bit of Southeast Asia.
Yes.
So do you think it's a reiterating market for you here for them?
Yes, of course. I think the more number of times we can meet our partners, our end users from as many countries as possible, it's always good to connect with them and to take hear to their problems and find solutions to the problem statements that they give us.
Right, and USA also is in full strength. This time the pavilion from USA is got by the US Army. So how are you trying to tap US?
So traditionally we have been a little away from the American market, but in the year 2024, as a new strategic initiative, we are exploring some good partnerships in the US. And hopefully by the end of the year, we will be having some good concrete news to share with you.
And out of the Quad countries, Australia and Japan are left. Where do you stand with both of them?
We have been doing a lot of work with the Japanese Coast Guard, with the Air Force armoring their equipment. So we do a lot of work in Japan and we continue to focus in that market.
And Australia?
So Australia, we're exploring partnerships there as well, and once there is positive news, we'll be happy to share with you on that as well.
Thank you so much, Karan. That was wonderful.
Thank you.
And by the time we meet again, I'm sure you'll have lots to tell us.
Thank
Thanks
you.
A ton.
Thank you.